you go over to the duck hiding on the wings, those are called wing riders. They actually start out on the top and will stay there. But in this case, we reenact the wing walking the way it was done in the golden age of aviation, as it's known, the period between the wars, between the end of World War I, which was 1918. So 1919 up until World War II started was called the golden age, is called the golden age of aviation. And the a scary feeling. You climb out of that cockpit and that 9-foot propeller is generating a tornado down the length of the fuselage. And these names of the airplane parts mostly come from the French. Fuselage, empennage, ailerons, things like that. Anyway, fuselage is the body. Charlie Schwenker will actually throttle way back just above stall, put it into kind of a glide to allow her to get out of the cockpit and walk along that wing. Which I believe she has done. She is out on the left wing of the airplane. I know it's hard to see way there, but I'm used to looking at it. And Charlie was just, you get back just above stall or almost into a glide and throttle the engine back. That way when the wing walker gets out of the cockpit, what they do is they hang onto the flying wires, and you'll have to step very carefully on the intersection of the leading edge, the spar, the wing spar, and the leading edge wing spar, and the ribs. It makes a little T. The rest of the wing is fabric. Well, it's all fabric covered, but so you want to step on the strong parts. Otherwise, you'll fall through the wing. Now, on this pass, Jana, I think we'll just stand there and wave to everybody. Wind pressure is tremendous. As you can see, Charlie's got the airplane. He's got his stick pushed way over to the right, kicking a lot of right rudder. And we can wave to her. And she's doing one of these numbers. Okay, now she's back into the strut. And what she will do, the strut is the, if you look over there at the airplanes, you'll see the struts are on the, between the wings, and they hold the wings together. There's actually four wings to a biplane. And it's quite a deal to rig those things. It takes a real skill. You don't just bolt them on there. You bolt them on and then you tension up those wire braces and get everything precisely right. And then when it's in true, the airplane will fly correctly. On this pass, Jana Lee McWhorter will lower herself under the wing and let go with her hands, swinging under the wing by her ankles. Now, we don't have any wing walking posters. We hope to get those out here next week. But you can meet her after the show, and if you have anything you'd like to have her sign for an autograph, she'll be happy to do it. Under the wing! Down, you ready for this? At 100 miles an hour, no parachute, no restraining devices. Look at that, folks! Hanging by her ankles under the wing. And now she's got to sit up into the wind at 100 miles an hour. Oof! Can she make it? Oof! She did it. Now you have to get all the way back into the cockpit. And again, stepping on the intersection of that leading edge spar. The wing, the spar is what is the strong part of the wing. It's a big piece of wood that runs down the length of the wing. So you step on that where it joins the ribs, and the ribs and the steerman are spaced. Well, you'll see it when you come up here. You'll see how they're spaced apart so that if you were to step on the fabric, you'd fall through. Now Jana Lee McWhorter is going to climb up onto the top wing. What we're doing is reenacting very accurately the way the barnstorming air shows were put on in the 20s and 30s. This is pretty much what you would see on a Sunday afternoon in 1933, 1934, all across the country, various little air shows, the Flying Aces with Jim and Jesse Woods. Jesse Woods was another famous lady wing walker. Gladys Ingalls was another one. She pioneered the wing walking. Ormer Locklear was another one, and he really pioneered it back in 1917, starting with the Army Air Signal Corps, as it was known, or Signal Corps Air Division. He climbed out of the cockpit one day and adjusted the carburetor, and everybody on the ground thought that was cool. And he grew that into a complete wing walking, dangling, wing changing, all sorts of deals act. All right, now Jana Lee McWhorter is on the top wing, and we are going to loop the airplane. Hang on. At 150 miles an hour, we loop the airplane with Jana Lee McWhorter standing on the top wing. Up we go! And over the top! Hang on! Airplane rides will start very shortly after the airplane show ends, and is a perfect day to take Mom, get her up for an airplane ride. The winds are basically nothing, and it's a gorgeous sunny afternoon. Okay, get your cameras rolling. Here comes a good photo op right here. You ready? It's a cross-control special where he's got the stick to the right, rudder to the left, and basically full throttle, as you heard it, to get that nice knife-edge pass with a heavy airplane. These airplanes, the PT-17 Cadets, were really put through a punishing grind in World War II. About 1.5 to 2 million pilots learned to fly in World War II. Civilian pilot training, Navy pilots, Army Air Corps. Many never actually saw service, active duty, but they were trained anyway. And we ended up with a lot of pilots after World War II that were ready to get into the civilian market. And the Where's Bob Nolan? Enemy. All right, now, those of you with cameras, bring them up along right where he's got this nice, and you won't need anywhere near that telephoto lens. If you just got a little small camera, come up along the fence right here. We're going to position the airplane right where I'm standing, with Jana Lee McWhorter standing on the top wing. So you can, if you want to go ahead and get your focus on my stripes, and that way I'll move, and you'll have your depth of field set. That's the landing, a three-pointer. Isn't that nice? This is the way most fields looked in World War II, little grass fields where people would learn to fly. Here so he could see. These are tail dragger airplanes, and you can't see forward. You have to look out the sides of the airplane to see where you're going. So Charlie's doing S turns. go. Great shot.